cleaned out the tubes. Hopefully. It's Rick Adams here in London on the BBC World Service with Wright Round the World. Now, you remember last week Steve asked you to tell us the origin of the saying, pull the other one. And here are some of your answers from our big answer phone.
Hello, my name is Andrew McIntosh and I'm ringing from Gibraltar. I think the phrase comes from in olden times when people used to go to English pubs. The landlord would have his nice bitter, and he'd have his other bitter that was just for travellers coming through. And if he pulled the wrong bitter, it wasn't going to be the nice one for the people. So he'd say, pull the other one, please, barman. And that's where we get the phrase. Well, that's what I think, anyway.
I'm Mary from Northern Ireland. The reason they say, pull the other one that's got bells on it, is because it goes back to the time of bell ringing when the priest played a joke on the congregation.
Hi, Steve. My name's Alison. I'm calling from San Francisco. I think to pull the other one means, do you take me for a fool? And I think it originates from the bell being pulled on a jester's costume.
Ah, yes. Thank you for that, Alison, at last. On the line there from San Francisco, you're completely and utterly right. The expression pull the other one, meaning, do you take me for a fool, dates back to the days of the court jester. For instance, my producer Dave told me I'd be presenting this show with Pamela Anderson. I said, pull the other one, Dave, what are you thinking of? In actual fact, the full phrase is, pull the other one, it's got bells on it. Probably referring to the bells in the jester's costume, I hope. So thanks also to everyone else who called, faxed and emailed us this week. The email address is ws.pop@bbc.co.uk if you want that. Also thanks to Bill Harvey from California in the USA, Alec Rylands in Oman, Naveed Singh from Pakistan, Eric Wolf from Pennsylvania in the US, and Maria Santos in Santiago. Well done to you lot. Now everyone who got it right was put into the draw, and the first name out of the hat, and the winner of the BBC World Service T-shirt. Yes, maybe one day. I lie awake dreaming about a BBC World Service T-shirt. The winner is Tommy Afrere from Lagos in Nigeria. Tommy, it's yours. And if it doesn't fit, you can use it as a duster. Now, this week, to blacklist someone is our saying. To blacklist someone. Well, what does that mean? The meaning is to exclude someone from an activity because of unsuitability. Bit of a mouthful, that lot. For example, Steve Wright is blacklisted from the BBC canteen because he's always complaining about the BBC coffee. So that's the example. If you know the answer to that one and you fancy a BBC World Service T-shirt, then you know what to do. Don't panic. Write into us at The Saying, Right Round the World, BBC World Service, Bush House in London. Or you could also drop us a line on, it's ws.pop@bbc.co.uk, that's the email. Or fax us on London 207-765-3945. Or telephone us on 207, that's London 207-636-7849.
My heart and soul's for you, and you should know I'll do anything you want me to. Move your body round, come on and get on down. It's the summer of love. Move your body round, get off and get on down. It's the summer of love. Sending out an SOS. Bad boys in the club, all they wanna do is feel the heat of summer love. Move your body round, come on and get on down. It's the summer of love. Move your body round and get up and get on down. It's the summer of love. Sending out an SOS. It's the summer of love. Sexy girls are down to get ready. It's the summer of love. Sending out an SOS. Summer of love, baby, cool, you got an impress. Check it out, Momoa, Chica. Come see ya kickin' it down. Sweet B, ya kickin' it down. G-Man, kickin' it down. Come on and get on down. It's the summer of love. Move your body round. Get up and get on down. It's the summer of love. Sending out an SOS.
That's Lonyo and Summer of Love. It hasn't quite arrived in this country yet. I think it's scheduled for November sometime. And now, another bizarre news story from around the world. Two Swiss Cherrystone spitters set new world records in Zurich as they took the sport's world titles back from US holders. Conchita Kohler won the woman's title by firing a Cherrystone 19 meters, while Thomas Steinhauer took the men's record with a distance of 25.2 meters. The Swiss Cherry Pick Spitters Association holds five or six competitions a year with 500 to 1,500 participants. Before spitting the stone, competitors have to eat the cherry, and some consume up to 50 in a match. Surprisingly, the association has 600 members. Well, Steve gets all the best jobs, and a few weeks ago in the studio with Steve was legendary vocalist Tony Bennett. I saw him at Leeds Castle a couple of weeks ago. He's brilliant. And we gave you a chance to win one of five copies of Tony's brand new CD called Ellington Hot and Cool. Now, Steve asked you to name the American city according to one of his greatest hits that Tony Bennett lost his heart in. And the answer was, you guessed it, San Francisco. I don't think Munich, Tobago or Wagadoodoo would have sounded quite so good. And the first five correct answers picked out came from the following. Sammy Gallini from Accra in Ghana. Andre Hopkins from Antwerp in Belgium. Keith Phillips from St. Michael in Barbados. Maybe we can come and do the show there one week. That'd be nice. Don Nelson from Tirana in Albania. And Jessica Morrison from Riga in Latvia. So congratulations. Well done to you lot. And we'll pop you each a copy of Tony's new CD in the post very shortly. Now, we've talked enough about the master, so let's hear him in action. And here he is, Tony Bennett, with his classic, I Left My Heart in San Francisco.
The loveliness of Paris seems somehow sadly gay. The glory that was Rome is of another day. I've been terribly alone and forgotten in Manhattan. I'm going home to my city by the bay. I left my heart in San Francisco. High on a hill, it calls to me to be where little cable cars climb halfway to the stars. The morning fog may chill the air. I don't care, my love waits there. in San Francisco. Above the blue, and when DC, when I come home to you, San Francisco.
Bennett, and I left my heart in San Francisco. This is Wright Around the World from Bush House in London with me, Rick Adams.
Making friends for the world to see. Let the people know you got what you need. Making friends for the world to see. If your friends are there, then everything's all right.
Yes, it's time for us here at the BBC World Service to give you a hug. We're putting you in touch with more listeners from around the world. And this week, Navroop Singh Tiara from Punjab in India. It's your turn. He writes, I'm a 20-year-old guy, 6 feet tall, and I'm currently studying medical studies at university. In fact, I'm working towards an MBBS, that's a Bachelor of Medicine and a Bachelor of Surgery. I'm not afraid of the sight of blood, it's just as well. My hobbies include reading books, listening to music of all types, especially songs that touch the heart. I like making new friends and keeping in touch with those I've already got. I'm also into car racing, and most importantly, I like laughing a lot, as it increases the blood circulation and keeps me happy. Sounds like a good prescription, Doctor. My ultimate ambition is to be a Formula One racing champion, and I'm already on the road to success. As I mentioned, I like music, and my favorite artists include Bon Jovi, Bryan Adams, Elton John, Celine Dion, Backstreet Boys, Savage Garden, and a number of Indian artists. I'd like to hear from people all over the world, and will be grateful, if possible, if you could include a photograph. Ah, yes. It always helps. So if you'd like to write to Navroop, he's got lots of interests, likes reading books, music, of course, and he's studying for those two bachelordoms, which is nice. If you want to get in touch with him, then you send a letter basically to the following address, Making Friends, in brackets, India, Right Round the World, BBC World Service, Bush House in London. That's Making Friends, in brackets, India, Right Round the World, BBC World Service, Bush House in London. Now, Navroop added on his letter, can you please play Always by Bon Jovi for my parents and all my friends, but importantly for my girlfriend, Messi. That is a great name. Sounds like my girlfriend, actually. She's my one and only love for always and forever. Well, I think you scored an A in romance there, actually, Navroop. So why not let us help you score an A plus by playing the song you wanted. Here's Always and Bon Jovi on the BBC World Service, Right Round the World with Rick Adams.
This Romeo is bleeding. You can't see his blood. It's nothing but some feelings that this old dog kicked up. It's been raining since you left me. Now I'm drowning in the flood. You see, I've always been a fighter, but without you, I give up. Now I can't sing a love song like the way it's meant to be. Well, I guess I'm not that good anymore, but baby, that's just me. Yeah, I will love you, baby. Always and I'll be forever and a day. Behind all just memories of a different life. Some that made us laugh, some that made us cry, one that made you have to say goodbye. What I'd give to run my fingers through your hair, touch your lips, to hold you. when you say your prayers. Try to understand, I've made mistakes, I'm just a man. When he holds you close, when he pulls you near, when he says the words you've been needing to hear. I wish I was him, with the words of mine to save you till the end.
And always. Oh, I'm filling up. Has anyone got any tissues? And now, another bizarre news story from around the world. And we go to Berkeley, California. Nearly 90 years after an Indian known as Ishi walked out of the wilderness and was put on display as the last wild man in North America, his brain is being brought back home from the Smithsonian Institute to California for a proper burial. Indians from California are scheduled to take possession of a jar containing Ishi's brain in a private ceremony at the Smithsonian in Washington, D.C. They'll reunite Ishi's brain with Ishi's cremated remains, which have spent decades in a cemetery south of San Francisco. Okay, it's time to put on my detective outfit now as we search for your lost friends. As you know, here on Right Round the World, as well as finding you new pen pals, we're also in the business of helping you track down lost friends. What do you think we call the BBC World Service? And this week, we've had letters from a number of you who, for one reason or another, are trying to trace various people. Now, Ferdy Pietus from South Africa is looking for her good friend, Quentin Schultz. She says they grew up together in South Africa, but when he moved to Sweden, they lost contact with each other. It's only recently that Ferdy's realized how much she misses Quentin, and until now, she'd given up all hope of ever tracing him. It's really sad when that happens. She also goes on to say that between 1998 and 1999, she spent some time in Israel at a kibbutz called En Gedi. She still has many happy memories from that time and is now looking to get back in touch with some of her fellow ex-volunteers. So if you're called Quentin Schultz, you grew up in South Africa and then moved to Sweden, then it would make Ferdy Pietus's day to hear from you again. Or alternatively, if you remember Ferdy from the En Gedi Kibbutz in Israel, she was there between 1998 and 1999. So if you remember, then she'd love to hear from you too. You can also send your letters into the usual address, which is Lost Friends, Wright Around the World, BBC World Service, Bush House in London. Alternatively, you could fax us, that's London 207 765 3945, or email the programme. It works. It's ws.pop@bbc.co.uk. And thanks to all of you who've written in. We do read all of your letters, and we'll try to get through as many of them as we can. And now, good luck with your search, Ferdy, of course. Now, you may remember Navroop. We were making friends with him a little bit earlier on. Well, we've got a bit of a double whammy for him, because his favourite bands, one of them, of course, is Savage Garden. I think he's taking over the show. Here it is.
Never set upon an argument. I believe we place our happiness in other people's hands. I believe the junk food tastes so good because it's bad for you. I believe your parents did the best job they knew how to do. I believe that beauty magazines promote low self-esteem. I believe that love will uncover. Sexuality. I believe that trust is more important than monogamy. I believe your most attractive features are your heart and soul. I believe that family is worth more than money or gold. I believe that struggle for financial freedom is a fair. To your unhappiness. I believe that where the business gets the need to be undressed. I believe that God does not endorse TV evangelists. I believe in love surviving death into eternity. I believe in karma, what you give is what you get returned.
At the controls here in London on the big BBC World Service right round the world. And of course, Steve's back next week. Okay, let's open up the birthday file. This week, best wishes go out to Anish Rai from Nepal, Tella Opeolu in Nigeria, Salid Salam in India, Mohammed Elabid in Egypt, Michael Uti in Nigeria, and James Wahomi from Kenya. Happy birthday to all of you. Send us some cake if you like. Actually, don't do that. Maybe you should fax it instead. Now, the birthday card and t-shirt this week goes to Kimemwe Nkoma in Malawi. He'll be celebrating his 26th birthday on Thursday. And that means he was born in August 1974, and that was the month when Richard Nixon became the very first president of the United States to resign after his involvement in the Watergate scandal. Bangladesh was in crisis as heavy monsoon rains flooded over half the country, causing many deaths and leaving millions homeless. Turkish tanks rolled into the Greek Cypriot port of Famagusta in Cyprus as rule for the island intensified. And finally, the government of Portugal announced a two-year plan to give independence to Angola. But the number one single in the UK 26 years ago was this one. Recognize it? It was When Will I See You Again? And of course, it's a 3 degrees. I haven't heard this for ages. Make them like that anymore, or the records. That's the 3 degrees, with their number one from 1974. It was so good that even I can remember it, and I was three at the time. Oops, I think I've made Dave, our producer, feel rather old. Sorry, Dave. I've got some interesting facts from my fact file here that I thought might tickle your fancy. Did you realize that bubblegum actually contains rubber? Most American car horns honk in the key of F. If you're doing musical, very useful. Now, this is a fascinating one. Termites eat wood 2 times faster when listening to rock music. So your house is more likely to fall apart if you're listening to Bon Jovi. And butterflies taste with their feet. Now, that's interesting. Oh, what did I just step in? Ugh. Okay, well, listen, if you'd like to get in touch with Navroop, who was featured on this week's Making Friends, then send your letter to the following address. It's Making Friends, and then in brackets, India, Wright Around the World, BBC World Service, Bush House in London. Make sure you spell Wright with a W, gets very upset. That's the same address, just omit the country in brackets if you want to be featured on the slot. So that's just making friends, obviously. Write us a long letter telling us everything about yourself we need to know. And include a phone number if you have one, because we'll give you a bell. And you never know, you might find yourself on the BBC World Service. Now, do you know where we get the saying to blacklist someone from? We want to know where and why this expression was first used. Please tell us. You can phone us on London 207-636-7849. You can fax us on London 207-765-3945. Or why don't you email us? Go on. You know you want to. ws.pop@bbc.co.uk. Plus, we're also after your nominations for the world's worst record. It's going to be difficult to top this week's, but I know you can do it. Also, can you do impressions? I can do a Sean Connery. Okay, Miss Money Penny. Okay, Miss Money Penny, let's go shopping. Okay, pretty rubbish. But if you can do better than that, and I'm sure you can, then just send them in on a cassette. And if you're featured, we'll send you a package of goodies. Another BBC World Service t-shirt. We're going crazy. Right, that's it for now. And we finish this week with a brand new single from Madonna. It's called Music. But...
Hey, Mr. DJ.
Yes?
Put a record on.
I am. Don't panic, because Steve is back next week. And make sure you tune in.
Madonna's new single, it's called Music, and it's ending this week's Wright Around the World. And Steve Wright himself will be back at the same time next week.